Welcome to the Amazing Car News Channel.
Genesis is continuing its model expansion with a midsize SUV, the GV70. This is a review of the twin-turbo V6 flagship. Hyundai's luxury offshoot, Genesis, has introduced the latest addition to its expanding lineup, as the burgeoning brand plans to open more showrooms in Brisbane and Melbourne in addition to the initial locations in Metro Sydney. The 2021 Genesis GV70, a midsize SUV that aims to compete against the Audi Q5, BMW X3, Mercedes-Benz GLC and Lexus NX, spans from $66,400 plus on road costs for a 2.5-liter turbo petrol model and stretches to the twin-turbo 3.5-liter V6 all-wheel drive that tops out at $83,400 plus on road costs. With options as tested, a $6,600 luxury package and $2,000 in matte paint, the price of the 2021 Genesis GV73.5 TAWD adds up to $92,000 plus on road costs, which is close to $100,000 in round numbers by the time you're in the traffic. There's little to differentiate the model range from the outside, beyond the standard 19-inch wheels on 4-cylinder or optional 21-inch alloys, which come as standard on the 3.5T. The engine description is nominated discreetly on a small badge on the tailgate. If you opt for the top-of-the-range twin-turbo V6 model, you get large exhaust tips to make it a little more obvious. The Genesis GV70 is roomy inside and comparable to most class rivals. Cargo space is generous too, though there is a space saver spare under the boot floor rather than a full-size spare. And the sloping rear roofline restricts some of the cargo hold. The cabin has a clean, simple and practical layout, with mood lighting and large digital screens to add to the ambience. There are ample charge points for front and back seat occupants, and generously sized door pockets, though the center console and glove box were modest in size. Helpfully, the front passenger also has a central locking switch, handy to operate if the driver runs an errand quickly and the occupants want to feel safe in the car. Oddly, despite being equipped with a sensor key and push-button start, the rear doors do not have sensors in the exterior handles. So when you're wrestling a load of shopping, you first need to pull on a front door handle before the rear will open. First world problem, sure, but we noted it because the Genesis otherwise has most other boxes ticked. There is good visibility all around due to the large-ish glass area, 360-degree camera display and wide-view side mirrors. The seats are comfortable and across the range the driver and front passenger have electric adjustment, as well as heating and cooling. The back seats tilt and split fold 60-40. There are two ISOFIX child seat mounting points and three top tether locations so you can fit an old-school child seat in the middle position. The center of the dash is dominated by a sleek 14.5-inch high-resolution infotainment screen that has wired Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, digital radio and embedded navigation. It has a clear view day or night and the 360-degree camera display is also excellent. The infotainment system can be controlled by a dial, similar to Mazda and Audi, but you also have the option of using the touchscreen, which minimizes a lot of frustration. Thank for watching.